shall solve problems on Cauchy general principle of convergence for series. The first problem is show that the series 1 by n, which is known as harmonic series, does not converge. We are going to solve this problem using by contradiction method. What's the contradiction method? Here we are going to assume that the series 1 by n converges. In the process, while we are continuing this problem, we will get a contradiction. The contradiction arises because of our supposition. Therefore, what we have to do is we have to change our supposition, or we have to change our assumption. That is, since we assume that the series 1 by n converges, now we have to conclude that the series 1 by n does not converge. That is by proof, by contradiction. Now, we assume here that the series 1 by n converges. Here, un is equal to 1 by n. Normally, we take the series as un or an, but here we have taken the series un. Therefore, un is equal to 1 by n. By Cauchy general principle of convergence for series. What is the statement of Cauchy general principle of convergence for series? We say that that statement says that series un is convergent if and only if for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n such that modulus of un plus 1 plus un plus 2 plus so on un plus p is less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equals to m and p is greater than or equals to 1. We are, as we told you, we are going to prove by contradiction. Now, every Telugu person is an Indian. It's a statement. It's a clear statement. Every Telugu person is an Indian. What is the converse of it? The converse of every Telugu person is an Indian is true. Is the converse true? No. The converse is not true. Why? Every Indian need not be a Telugu person. Actually, the converse of every Telugu person is an Indian is every Indian is a Telugu person. Right? The converse of every Telugu person is an Indian is every Indian is a Telugu person. But the converse is not true. So how we have to state? We have to state that every Indian need not be a Telugu person. So how to contradict the statement that every Indian is a Telugu person? To contradict every Indian is a Telugu person, we have to produce one example. We have to give one example of an Indian person who is not a Telugu person. For example, our president of India, namely Mr. Ramnath Kovind, is an Indian, but he is not a Telugu person. Therefore, every Telugu person is an Indian, its converse is not true. Its converse is not true. The reason is, our president of India, Mr. Ramnath Kovind, is an Indian but not a Telugu person. This type of example is called counterexample. What's the counterexample? We give one example which contradicts the statement. Similarly here, the statement of Cauchy general principle of convergence for series says that for every epsilon greater than 0, for every epsilon greater than 0. Now we are going to prove this theorem or the problem by contradiction. Therefore, we have to give one counter example. For this, we choose epsilon is equals to 1 by 4. This is like Mr. Ramnath Kovind, which is a, who is an Indian but not a Telugu person, right? So epsilon is equal to 1 by 4, say, which is positive. It's a positive. Then direction is m belongs to n, such that modulus of un plus 1 plus un plus 2 plus un plus so on, un plus p is less than 1 by 4 because epsilon value is 1 by 4. For all n is greater or equal to m and p is greater or equal to 1. That is modulus of what is un? Un is 1 by n. What is un plus 1? Un plus 1 is 1 by n plus 1. What is un plus 2? Un plus 2 will be 1 by n plus 2. What is un plus p? Un plus p will be 1 by n plus p. Therefore, modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus so on plus 1 by n plus p is less than epsilon, but epsilon equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, less than 1 by 4. It is true for all n is equals to m or greater than m and p is greater than or equals to 1. Since n can be equal to m, we choose n equal to m. And what is p? P is any number which is greater than 0, which is greater than 0. Therefore, we choose p is equals to m. And hence, this inequality 1 becomes. What do you have to do? Replace every n by m and p by m. Therefore, the inequality 1 becomes modulus of 1 by n plus 1. What is n? N is m. Therefore, we write 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2. What is n? M. Therefore, it is 1 by m plus 2. So on 1 by n plus p. What is n? M. What is p? M. Therefore, it is 1 by m plus m. And hence, that is equals to modulus of 1 by m plus 1 plus 1 by m plus 2 plus so on plus 1 by m plus m. We know that m plus 1 is less than m plus m because m is equal to m and the m value is more than 1. Therefore, m plus 1 is less than m plus m. This implies, take the reciprocal of it. If we take the reciprocal of this, 1 by m plus 1 is greater because the inequality. Whenever we have an inequality, if we multiply an inequality with a minus sign or negative value, the inequality will be reversed. Or when you take the reciprocal, the inequality will be reversed. Since here we are taking the, we are writing the reciprocal, therefore it is 1 by m plus 1 greater than 1 by m plus m. Similarly, 1 by m plus 2 greater than 1 by m plus m. 1 by m plus 2, 1 by m plus 3 greater than 1 by m plus m. 1 by m plus 4 greater than 1 by m plus m. 1 by m plus m is equals to 1 by m plus m. And hence, the above step is equals to each one is greater than 1 by m plus 1. 1 by m plus m. That is 1 by m plus 1 is greater than 1 by m plus m. 1 by m plus 2 is greater than 1 by m plus m. 1 by m plus m is equal to 1 by m plus m. Therefore, this is the above modulus is greater than 1 by m plus m plus 1 by m plus m plus 1 by m plus m plus so on plus 1 by m plus m. Here we have not written the modulus. You know why? Because what is m? M is a natural number and hence modulus not required. How many terms are here? 1 by m plus m terms. There are m terms because here this is the first term, 1. This is the second term, 2. This is the mth term. Therefore, there are m terms, namely 1 by m plus m. And hence, the next step will be, this step is equal to, the above step equals to, there are m factors, 1 by m plus m. Therefore, m into 1 by m plus m, that is equal to m into 1 by m plus m is 2m, m cancel, that is equals to 1 by 2. Thus, modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus so on 1 by n plus p is here equal, here greater, here equal. So what do you have to write? We have to write this is greater than 1 by 2. See here. Therefore, the modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 so on 1 by n plus b is greater than 1 by 2. Call it as 2. Now from 1 and 2, what does 1 say? 1 say 1 by 2 is less than. 1 by 2 is less than modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus so on 1 by n plus b. But what does 2 say? 1 say the equation 1, inequality 1 says that the modulus is less than 1 by 4. Less than 1 by 4. So from 1 and 2, we are using transitive property. We start with 2, then we use 1. And hence, from 1 and 2, 1 by 2 is less than modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus 1 by n plus 3 so on 1 by n plus b, which is less than 1 by 4. That means 1 by 2 is less than 1 by 4. Which is greater? Which is greater? 1 by 4 is greater, 1 by 2 is greater. 1 by 2 is half. 1 by 4 is quarter. Which is greater? 1 by 2 is greater, but here we have arrived at 1 by 4 is greater than 1 by 2. Is it true? No, not at all. This is not true. This is absurd. This is a contradiction. Why this is absurd? Why this is contradiction? This contradiction arises due to our supposition. What is our supposition? The series 1 by n converges. Therefore, we have to change our assumption, our supposition. That is, we have to change. What do you have to change? The series 1 by n does not converge. Show that series 1 by 2n minus 1 does not converge. We are going to use proof by contradiction to solve this problem. Let, if possible, the series 1 by 2n minus 1 be convergent. So let us take u and b, 1 by 2n minus 1. Therefore, u suffix n plus 1 will be 1 by, replace n by n plus 1 in u n. Therefore, u n plus 1 will be 1 by 2 into n plus 1 minus 1. That is equals to, if you simplify this, 1 by 2n plus 2 minus 1. That is 2n plus 1. Therefore, u n is 1 by 2n minus 1. U n plus 1 is 1 by 2n plus 1. Now, let us choose the epsilon equal to 1 by 8, which is positive. See, epsilon must be positive. What will be the value? However small, it must be positive. Let us choose epsilon equal to 1 by 8. Since the series un is convergent by Cauchy general principle of convergence for series. For a given epsilon 1 by 8, that x is m belongs to n, such that modulus of un plus 1 plus un plus 2 plus so on plus un plus b less than 1 by 8 for all n greater or equal to m and p is greater than or equals to 1, call it as 1. In particular, let us put n equal to m and p equals to m. Then what happened to this? Since we know un is 1 by 2n minus 1, what is un plus p? Un plus p will be 1 by replace n by n plus p. So 2 times n plus p minus 1 is equal to 1 by 2n plus 2p minus 1 is equals to 1 by 2n plus 2p minus 1 is u suffix n plus p. Therefore, modulus of un plus 1 plus un plus 2 plus so on un plus p equals to 1 by 2n plus 1 plus 1 by 2n plus 3. What is un plus p? 1 by 2n plus 2p plus 1 by 2n plus 2p minus 1. Now, we have to keep n is equal to m, p equal to m. Therefore, the above equation, the modulus becomes 1 by 2m plus 1 plus 1 by 2m plus 3 plus so on 1 by what is n? M. What is p? M. Therefore, it is 2m plus 2m minus 1, that is 1 by 4m minus 1. Therefore, this becomes 1 by 4n minus 1. That is same as 1 by 2m plus 1 plus 1 by 2m plus 3 plus so on 1 by 4m minus 1. We have removed the modulus because m is a positive natural number. All the natural numbers are positive. So m is a natural number, and hence we need not keep modulus here. Now, 2m plus 1 is less than 4m minus 1 because 4m minus 1 will be more than 2m plus 1. Now, take the reciprocal. So its reciprocal will be 1 by 2m plus 1 is greater than 1 by 4m minus 1. What is 4m minus 1? Normally, whatever we comparing this will be the last term. Will be the last term. Even the previous problem also, we have compared first term with the last term, second term with the last term with the last term. Similarly here, the first term is greater than last term. Similarly, what happened? 1 by 2m plus 3 will be greater than the last term, namely 1 by 4m minus 1. So each and every term is greater than the last term. But the last term is equal to last term. Therefore, the above equation becomes greater than. Because each term is greater than the last term. So 1 by 2m plus 1 is greater than 1 by 4m minus 1 plus 1 by 2m plus 3, that is greater than 1 by 4m minus 1. So on, the last term is 1 by 4m minus 1. How many terms are there? There are m terms. There are m terms. See here, we have 1 here. What is that? There are m terms. Yeah, p equal to m. P equal to m. We are taking p equal to m. Therefore, see here, 1, 2, p. What is p? P is m. And hence, there are m terms. Therefore, there are m terms, each term is 1 by 4m minus 1, therefore that is equal to m minus 1 by, sorry, m, sorry, that is equals to m into 1 by 4m minus 1, call it as 2. So from 1 and 2, what is 2 says? 2 says m by 4m minus 1 is less than the modulus value, this value. Therefore, m by 4m minus 1 is less than 1 by 2m plus 1, 1 by 2m plus 1, 2m plus 3, so on, 1 by 4m minus 1. But the same thing is less than 1 by 8 in equation number 1. 1 by 8 by equation number 1. Therefore, from 1 and 2, we have m by 4m minus 1 is less than 1 by 8. Now, cross multiplying. 8m is less than 4m minus 1. Transpose this 4m to the left hand side. Therefore, 8m minus 4m is simply 4m less than minus 1. This implies m is less than minus 1 by 4. So, m value must be less than minus 1 by 4. So, what does it mean? M takes all negative values. M will not take any positive value at all. But therefore, what happened here? When you say m is less than minus 1 by 4, it means m does not belong to n. M cannot be a natural number. But what is m? M is always a natural number. But here we have arrived at m is not a natural number. Therefore, which is a contradiction to the fact that m is a natural number. And thus, the given series is not convergent.